Alrighty, hello. I have been lighting some interior environments in Unreal lately, and I'm gonna do a quick little video run through of my work. Give you all a bit of an insight. So essentially what I'm doing here is I am creating torches, flame torches. So with lighting this environment, I've been given the scene, the geometry, all of the objects in it. It's all pre-built, it's all placed for me. So all I have to do is come in and light the space, give it its life. So how I'm doing that mainly is that prior to doing the interior lighting, I've been setting up a sky, making a sky dome, adding a skylight in. I'm using HDR images and adapting them in Photoshop, adjusting exposure, really just looking at adjusting the photos depending on the amount of light I want the sky to emit onto the scene. For this level, at least this version of the level that I'm doing and that I'm lighting the interior for today, it's not during the daytime as such. It's going to be closer to evening, so it's going to be a bit darker. But I'm not really going to be explaining how I lit the sky and everything. So started by making the torches. A really neat thing you can do in Unreal is that you can adjust color based on temperature, which is really cool. So as you can see, what I've been doing here is that I've set all of these torches around, and particularly in this dungeon, adjusting their temperature value to give it a bit more life to the light. And that's how I'm getting the nice orangey ready glow, which looks like a flame torch, even though it hasn't got the particle assigned with it. So what I'm doing here is I'm setting up additional spotlights to give off the effect that light is filling this space as if this was a torch. Because the base of my torch is a point light, or an omni light, it doesn't really fill the space in a natural way. So as you can see here, I'm adjusting it to get really nice shadows and get nice contrast. It's really been my focus with lighting this interior, is to get the contrast, to create really nice shadows, and to work with the color of the light and make the space interesting to walk through and explore. Which also brings me to player path. So player path is really important in games. And particularly in this scene, I've been trying to generate points of interest for players. So here I'm just moving around my torches to get a bit more of a feel of first entering this castle, this ruin. So one of the things with creating shadows is that I didn't want to have too much black, right? You don't want a scene to be dark. If it can be lit, it probably should be lit. As you can see, the back of this castle is a cave, and the light that's coming in from this ruin area at the start is brought in from the sky, and you don't want that necessarily to make it all the way into the back of this cave, which is why I'm bringing in these omni lights to fill out the cave and put some light into this lava. So at the moment I'm just setting these up, just doing a really rough block out, trying to get some light into this cave, and give it a bit more character so that you can actually see what's going on. So the big things that I've been focusing on with lighting the interior is that the methods that I've used to light it are not always going to be realistic. They're not always going to be true. They're not going to be logical, and most of all, they're not going to be literal. So a good example of that is right now, where I'm really shining some white light onto this throne, because it's an important piece in this scene. And even though this light that's being shined onto it isn't natural, it couldn't possibly be there unless there was a light fixture, which doesn't make sense in this scene, as you can see by the geometry. But as you can see here, when you adjust it and you work it together with the other lights around it, and you work on your contrast and your shadows and just the color, you get some really interesting things happening with your scene. And you'll find that when players move through it, they're going to be drawn to these points of interest, which is really important in games. So just trying to fill out the scene a bit more here. Not too much. I am going to come through and do some rim lighting and some fill lighting just to get a bit more character, maybe up the intensity, and fill out this cave's interior a little more than it is. It's also important in this cave that there is too much to be lit, which is to realize when you're lighting interiors, especially cave interiors for that matter, I imagine. You don't want the whole space to be lit, because then it's not intriguing, it's not interesting, it's too fake, I guess. You want your lighting to be realistic, as you can see here, with this initial Omni light here. By extending its radius, the light from it comes out further, and it generates this really interesting contrast with the shadow as you enter in, and it's overall intriguing. But you don't want to lose those shadows, because that's what generates the interest more than the light does. And just doing a few touch-ups here, trying to really focus in on that shadow. That dungeon's probably a little dark, but the thing is that this is a block out before my initial building pass. So I haven't compiled the lighting or anything. Doing some rim lighting here, trying to really shine on this big rock fixture in the middle. Changing the temperature so that the color is the same as the rest of the light. Rest of the cave, sorry. So this way, though, if and when a player were to move through here, there would be more emphasis on this central structure, when you round that initial corner. And same here, like you can see that the lava would be emitting natural light from its color. And even though I'm using a spotlight, which isn't literal in how that rock would be lit by the lava, it gives off the same impression. Doing some adjustments, getting some really nice spec highlights on the armor in this scene. So here's another example of non-literal lighting. Just going through on this side of this main room, giving it some fill lighting, because otherwise it's just black and it's not attractive to the player. And same here with the left side, where there's a lot more armor. There's these weapons, these shields, these armor plates, piles of rubble, tapestries, all sorts of things. You want to highlight them to the player. They may not be interactable, but they are interesting features of this environment. And if you're working with environment artists, texture artists, and all those other roles that go into building building the environment, building the level, they've put in the work to make these pieces to fit out this space, and you want your players to experience that. And that's why we go through and we do things like fill lighting, which again aren't natural, but natural light has its way of filling out spaces, and to do that, we can use techniques like spotlights at interesting angles. And for instance, here I'm trying to get some really nice natural light through this crack, and this is going to be a really, really strong focal point for players when they move through this starting room. They're going to notice this crack. They're going to see the shadow cast onto this broken pillar before they enter the cave. And ultimately, when they first enter this ruin from in here, they're going to notice that above all else. And yeah. So you can probably see that the textures on the floor don't exactly match up, and that's it's annoying to say the least. As a lighting artist, it is lighting for games is a very it's a very touchy job. It's all about quality. It's all about iterating and getting the scene to a state that you're happy with, that the environment artist is happy with. And something that's important to note here is that with these torch fittings, where I've placed them doesn't make sense with the environment that I've been given, or the geo in the environment. So back there, it's not insane at the moment, but there is a torch that I've placed onto a broken pillar. Now, I placed it there because it feels right for the space. It feels right for the scene. It draws, to me, it draws the player in to the space, and it's gonna ultimately be more intriguing. And the thing is that when you're working with environment artists, level designers, and all that, and you collaborate with them and you talk to them and you explain that, well, if we put some lights here, it's gonna draw the player's eye, it's gonna encourage exploration, it's gonna overall make the scene more intriguing, and it's gonna benefit the game more. And then, you know, we can move geo around. They may agree, the whole scene may change by the time you get to shipping, and that's kind of just the reality of production. So just before I was putting a spotlight onto the door, just giving it a bit of feel light. If this was an earlier time of day, you may have seen in some of my early iterations of the exterior environment and lighting the scene initially, if it was the morning or midday, that you can get really nice shadows cast onto this front door, which highlight it to players, and that again is another motive to get the player interested in the scene and to draw their eye and to tell them where they need to be going. So I've just come back, just compiled my lighting, not too much to be worried about, and then come in, and this dungeon is a lot lighter than I initially planned for it to be. It's not bad how it is. It's fine. I'm not getting the shadows that I want. I'm not really, to me, it doesn't draw the player in as much as I'd like it to, especially from this initial view here. With those darker shadows that are casting across onto this wall where the spotlight is shining, from the main room, players are going to be intrigued by what that torch is, initially before they even know it's a torch. And same here with the shadow cast against this this pillar, it creates an inviting shadow and an interesting space to explore. Same thing here. Lost a little bit of a little bit of the emphasis on the shadows here, but it's easy enough to get them back. Do another build. This all looks pretty good. Just trying to fill this space out a little more. And that's the thing with lighting any environment, be it interior, exterior, whether you're doing cutscenes. There's always going to be things that you want to emphasize more than others. For instance, if you're going to be lighting cutscenes and there's characters in view, your lighting is going to have to complement cutscenes, to protagonists. Oh, sorry, the main player protagonist and perhaps a sidekick or a partner in the game. They may be conversing, and you want to emphasize mood and tone within the scene through your lighting. And you don't want the lighting to be too harsh in moments like that. And it's very much the same with this interior that I'm lighting. I don't want this cave to be bright, fully lit, bright, and I still want these pockets of shadow, these pockets of darkness, these pockets of like mystery and the unknown, because that in my head is where this level would be progressing to, even though the geometry at the moment doesn't allow for that. Further in a game, it could be that the player enters this ruin, works through this cave, gets an item from the throne, and then works their way out of the back of the cave, and then perhaps deep underground, perhaps up the mountain, which is behind this ruin, all sorts of things, and all of these things come into play when you're thinking about lighting and how you light your scenes. So just trying to get a bit more spec here on these items. I am liking this corridor, just on the right-hand side. There's some nice emphasis on these key points, and there's enough shadow behind the pillars that it's like, ooh, what's behind here? It's interesting. And another thing to note is that lighting is a very iterative process. You constantly iterate your work. You do a build, you come back and you have a look at it, and for example, what's happened with me, I wasn't happy with some things, so I'm going through and I'm doing some touch-ups. I'm turning lights to static from real time when they don't need to be. All sorts of considerations to the overall game. The experience and player pathing and the overall mood and tone that you want to set for your scene. So what I'm doing here is I'm adjusting the intensity of the sky to shine a little more natural light down into this opening. I don't want too much light to be coming from my sky. To be coming from my sky that is displayed inside. I want most of that exterior lighting to happen just here at this opening and outside where we're initially leading the player into this space. So again, just turning some lights here to static that don't need to be rendered at runtime. Keeping my spotlights so that I can get interesting shadows from the player. And then gonna go through now and just put some post-processing stuff through. Mainly gonna be looking up fog, making this scene a little more intriguing when you get inside. The The cave at the moment is fairly clear when you first walk in. You can see back quite a bit. It's not as moody as I'd like it to be, but here with a little bit of fog, just increase that a bit, alter the color. Already this scene is getting a lot more life to it. And that cave is already a lot more interesting from just a little bit of fog. So just gonna run another compile of the lighting. And as you can see here, this light here, I thought I got rid of. So again, I've made this dungeon too dark now, way too dark. I'm not getting any light, any interesting light. So this spotlight should be shining a lot more. So set that up and then go for another build. I think what I ended up with was something around about here where I'm getting some nice shine on those two chains straight ahead. But this scene, it's probably a little dark. It probably is a little dark. It could go through with a little bit more. Again, it's just something you need to play with. And then just making sure that I get some nice light casts off this one that are hitting this wall here, inviting players into that dungeon initially. Yeah, this cave's looking good. This fill light is looking good. Probably a little bright. But I like it. I like it. So already this is looking a bit more interesting. Just have a quick compile again with we can see a lot more definition in the shadows being cast from the flame torch just around the left, which is what I want. It invites me in, shows me that there's something around there that could be a point of interest. It's something that I don't know, and as players, we want to know things in the game world. And we're drawn to them. Just doing another little quick run through. As you can see here, the lava's not showing. That's due to being in game view. Not sure why, but just jumping back into the scene view, and we can see the scene as it should be. So this is demonstrating lighting only, so this is all the detailed lighting that's going on in the scene, without the textures. So you can get a lot a much better impression of where your lighting is, what it's affecting, without the distractions of the textures, which is important. And it's a really good tool to be using when you're lighting environments. Again, one of the important things is that all of these techniques that I'm doing and that I'm talking about now are they're for use of a better word, they're cross-platform. So these are all applicable lessons that you can that they can that you can take to lighting scenes in any engine. These are this is just how lighting works. So just here while it's in view, it's probably a little dark around the rock face near that broken pillar. I might want to go in there and do a little bit of rim lighting from the from the crack in the wall, just to make it a little more inviting than having this black surface. But as you can see here, I'm really just going through, checking my contrast, making sure that there's interesting meshes of color, of shadow, and making the scene intriguing and fascinating. I'm really liking the shadow getting cast from that light crack. It's good. So just here, I think there could be a little bit of fill lighting. Just a little bit, just to brighten that up. I mean, literally it makes sense that it be dark, I guess, because the light shining in from there would be the only thing that it's, you know, that's being emitted. When you come through though, it makes sense that the light from the sky just in front of us would be casting something against that wall. It'd probably be very low intensity, and honestly, you may not even notice it, but for the sake of a video game, you'd want to go through there and do a little touch up there just to make the scene more interesting for players. But yeah, thanks guys. Hope you enjoyed this little run through. Yeah, I'm not really gonna do any editing on my voice because, yeah, this was all just talking about my stuff.